Hello, hello, hello friends, and welcome back to my channel. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and I am back with another tutorial. So today I thought of doing this cute little simple tutorial on watercoloring. I love watercoloring, and it's been long since I posted any of my tutorial on this topic. And as the Christmas is coming, I'm sure Vanya wants to share and send lots of cards to her friends, so I thought let me start doing it. And I was traveling almost 15 days, and it was a fun trip to my hometown, a very fun trip but very tiring. And since I'm back, I've been just editing my previous videos, and it's really tiring for me. So I thought of doing this easy and de-stressing tutorial. So to start with, here I have my 6x4 card paper, and this is not a watercolor paper, this is just my regular white cardstock. This is approximately 200 GSM thick, which is not a perfect thing for my card making, but I thought why not to try my watercoloring on this. So I have been following many Pinterest images regarding the watercoloring, and I really love this tree themed card, so I thought of making one. In this, I am just going to blend in my color on my paper, and I'm going to play around with all the blue and greens and black shades. Like I said, I wanted this to be a de-stressing video, so I thought I'll do some chit-chat and I'll create this card. I love making cards. This is something which I started with the scrapbooks and cards, and then I switched to mixed media, which is one of my favorite thing now, and I still love making cards. Off camera, I make lots of cards, lots of gift tags, and I always use my handmade tags for my gifting, and Vanya loves flaunting them for her friends, birthday gifts and all, for any of the occasions actually. So yes, we do believe in making lots of handmade stuff, and you must be knowing Vanya has her own channel, so there also she loves creating cards and tags, and she's a big fan of Crafty Scrappers. I need to mention that, cause she loves using their supplies, and I think that's the best part. I also feel it's a very good way to bond with your kid, cause this is something which really connects us a little more. And we love watching tutorials, we love watching Pinterest, we love experimenting with our supplies. And yes, it also comes with a cost that I need to share all my supplies with her. Yes, she has always been like crazy for craft supplies, and I had mentioned this earlier also that my dad, he has a stationery shop, and he has like amazing collection of craft supplies and stationeries. So whenever we go to our hometown, we just get a bag full of supplies from there, and for 3-4 months we just keep on experimenting with that. So that is something we really love doing, and whenever we have time, like me and Vanya, we really bond together with doing lots of experiment. And I am super happy to see how she has developed her own sense of crafting, her own way of experimenting and coming up with new ideas. I'm also very happy to see her exploring new options, exploring new kind of craft, and the way she pursues them is really amazing. Like when I was young, I started with making scrapbooks. It was just a fun scrapbook. Me and my cousin, we did it on a old register, old notebook with a few newspaper cutouts and all. But then yeah, that for us, that was the starting. And then I did my interiors, and then I came into this full-time crafting once Vanya was born. So it's been more than 6 years now, but we thoroughly enjoy this. Okay, so now back to my video. So here I am going to use my watercolors. Like I said, I'm going to use the green, blues and the black shade. So I'm just adding water, making the base of my trees, and then I'm going to fill it up with little more color. I love Christmas trees and I love making Christmas cards, and I thought of adding shimmer paints to it. Yes, I have been using shimmer paints, and I've even done a video tutorial on watercoloring with shimmer paints. I will be linking that up. Do check that if you love watercoloring. So acrylic shimmer paints by Crafty Scrappers is a fab way to add a little drama to it. So right now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to fill my colors with, like, do my trees with the watercolors, and then I'm going to add my shimmer paints to it. I love watercoloring, but I still need to explore many other options of watercolor available in the market. This one is from Campbell, and this is one of the very basic shade, but yes, it has the variations, the good number of color variations in it, and I have been using it since long. So it is a good idea if you are starting with the watercoloring. You can explore these options for your basic coloring, and even if you go to the advanced level, I think this is going to be enough for your making cards and tags. I have been following few of the YouTubers, the crafters, the artists, those who do watercoloring, and I love a couple of them. I will be sharing their channel link below. Do check that if you are a beginner. See, what I do is the very basic one, the very simple cards, because this is something which is de-stresses me from my regular routine work. And like I said, I have been traveling, and then there were a bunch of videos to be edited, so it was super hectic for me and very tiring. So I thought of doing this very basic card. And you can even explore the different ways of watercoloring, and I have done a couple of more videos on watercoloring which you can check in my playlist, and I hope that helps. So whenever I do watercoloring, I always make sure that I have 2-3 jars of water with me if I'm playing with different colors. But for this one, my shades were very limited. I did not have to explore so much on my shades, so one jar is enough. And I love using glass jars for my watercoloring because I love seeing the flow of color in the water, and I love that. I think that's something which really soothes me, and I love watching the mixing of color and the blending of color, so that really interests me a lot. This is not a watercolor paper, and this is just the 200 GSM paper, and it is folding a bit, so but then that's fine because I'm going to stick this on a base and then prepare a card. But for my watercoloring, I should have taken a bit of paper, but then that's okay for now because this is just my first card of the season, and I'll be coming up with many more tutorials soon. Lately I have been doing many videos on mixed media projects, altered projects, decoupage projects, and I have a bunch of videos which are ready and I still need to edit and I need to publish them. And I'm really glad that many of the suppliers and the Indian craft supply brands are really helping me out with their supplies. They allow me to experiment with their supplies and shoot videos on my channel, and I'm really grateful because this really gives me an space to experiment with the different products. Like I even tried doing the texture paste, the not the typical white texture paste, but the color texture paste, because that was something which I really love using. I am a big fan of shimmer sprays, but yes, at times I love using my texture paste or the modeling paste as it is, and I don't want to add some color to it. So yes, I have been experimenting with the material a lot. If you're a beginner, I always say please go to the local market, explore the market, buy a few supplies and experiment a lot. If you are a beginner, you don't have to buy a hell lot of supplies and spend money on it. No, it's not that. It's not about the material. It's more about how you experiment with your supplies. Like when I started crafting, I remember I used to go to Avon Crafts, the Neha Gala store, and they had amazing collection. They used to really help me out that how to use the supplies. I was a beginner. I was just doing the very basic scrapbooking. I did not even knew about the tools. So Neha and Vikram, they were really, really warm, and they used to tell me everything on how to use the supplies, how to use the tools. And that's how I started doing the crafting. And now with so many supplies available in the Indian market, you have access to amazing collection of craft supplies, the tools, the paper packs, and you get them in all the range. So start with the very basic ones, have few supplies, experiment a lot, try a lot, and then switch to some other supply if you want to, because even with a limited supply you can really create wonders. I would also like to mention that many a times I've been asked that which paintbrush I use. I use the paintbrushes from Anukul brand. It's one of the Indian made brand, and I love using these brushes because I have been using brushes since long, and I have faced so many issues with the dry bristles and the colors doesn't come out, and then you need to clean it up and it's a big mess. And I have wasted lots and lots of money on that, and since I have started using this brand, I have never bought any other brand's brushes. And do check these ones also. They have those amazing collection of flat brushes, round brushes, the thicker one, the thinner ones, and they are way cheaper than your any of the branded brushes, and they really last long. I am also going to post the link of this brush store down in the description box. Do check that also. Here is a tip. Whenever you are using your paint brushes, make sure you clean them immediately. Second option what I tried is, if your color does not come out, you can always clean your brushes with some oil. Yeah, it sounds a little weird, but oil really helps in soothing the color. Like it becomes a little softer and then it becomes easy to clean. So first you clean your brushes with the soapy water, soak them in oil for some time, any oil, any kind of oil. I tried this with my refined oil and it worked for me. So you can dip them in the oil for say half an hour, 40 minutes, and then you clean it up with the liquid soap. It you can see the difference then and there only. So now my coloring is almost done and I'm pretty happy with it, and I think now I need to add some dimensions to it. So here what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the border marking. So this is one of the gel pens with the which is blue in color, and I thought this will work for me. So I'm just going to give the borders to my tree with a very light hand and make the stems. I will repeat the same for all the trees, and this even works for my black color, the black trees also. So yeah, it's a good choice. I think you can use any of your gel pen, you can even use your fine tip or fine tip fountain pen, or you can even use your fine tip marker pens to give this border. And I think this gel pen worked for my project. Now I am going to write my Christmas. So it's a Merry Christmas card, and I'm writing Merry Christmas, and my card is ready. This looks perfect now. I just feel that I need to add a little darker shade on my border, because I think I added a little more water to it. So I'll just give it a little darker shade and I'm done. And I'm going to add some tinge of blue to make it a dark night, to give it a dark night effect, and my card is ready. So I hope you'll enjoyed this tutorial. I will be doing some more videos on Christmas cards, so please stay tuned. And if you have any queries, please do comment below in the description box, and do not forget to share this with your friends. And please, please, please do check Vanya's videos on YouTube. Her channel name is Vanya Agarwal. I'm sharing the link in the description box. Do check that. Thank you so much for watching.